every deer hunt. Quite a bit of sign around this pine forest. I came in here the other day with my rifle, but I thought I'd sneak around with my bow today. Let's cruise around out here and see what happens. Take it nice and slow.
Here I am testing for the wind, just using this little bottle with some powder in it and just flicking it up, and you can tell which way the wind's going to be going. Always try and hunt into the wind, this way the deer won't smell you. Here I am trying to explain what happened. I just come on top of the ridge, and where I'm pointing there, there's a deer standing there, and as it bolted, I let out a little meh, and it got its attention, and it stopped just down where the dog was there, and gave me enough time to draw an arrow and put the shot away into its chest.
Put the pin on and boom. So it's just run off, I've heard it crash off. We're going to give it about half an hour or so. Then go into it.
Here I am calling the dog in with some chirps.
I've learned over the past that I've shot a deer and I've gone in too fast too soon, and they haven't been quite passed away, so I'm going to give it a good half hour this one. There's a good shot. I was shooting through this one, the tree leaning. I just had to shoot through that, so I was a bit worried that my arrow might deflect, but I placed my shot pretty well. That's a good 20-yard shot, I think, just through there. Far out. That's a good morning's hunt so far. So I saw it run across there, side of the cross. I've heard it sort of crash down a bit. Can't believe I just walked right past it just about. The dog was behind me, so he wouldn't have...
I carried on hunting after I'd shot the deer just to let it expire, and then I came back to the same spot and we got onto the deer and started tracking it. At this point, all I have to do is just follow Max now, and he'll lead me straight into it. Don't be in a hurry to track your deer, just let the dog take its time and just let the dog work the ground. think Max's tail is telling me a few stories. He looks pretty happy, doesn't he? You can see here the deer smashed into the tree. Leaving a bit of sign around.
This obviously come up here, smash into this tree here. Hey. That's a good boy, isn't it? Hey, you got a nice young hind. Got a 28 shot with a seeker stopper. Here, it's quartering away a bit downhill. So that's all good. Anyway, wait for the table. That's good, nice hind, nice leader.
We've just rolled her over. There's the entry wound on the, just below the spine there. It's come out through the chest there, which is perfect. Complete pass through with the Grim Reaper and the Seeker Stop arrow. A perfect shot, just the way she was angling. Well, there you have it, one down deer. The last few hunts have been on that tar hunt you might have seen on one of my other videos. I shot that bull and it is unrecoverable, I couldn't find it.
Got him. Didn't like that very much.
And then in early on the raw, I tried a nice seeker stag, came in and I never found that either. Following the blood trail, and it must have been quite close to it because I heard it crash off and run off, and we ended up tracking for like 2 hours through the bush, so I've learned a few lessons. The thing I've learnt now is just that give the animals a bit more time to
to pass away, so I gave this one a good hour just to be sure. That's the exit wound. Shooting downhill on her. So you've got to think about the where the exit wound's going to go. So coming through there and come out through there, so got the lungs. Probably an inch or two high, but alright, we've got a dog's done a good job finding it and tracking it. Yeah. Walk up this hill here and take the whole thing out, gutter out here and carry the whole thing. Hey boy, you did a good job, didn't you boy? Hey? You did a good job, ain't you boy, hey? Oh, the good boy, Max, aren't you? It's good boy. Yeah. He's a happy boy. So, for those newbie guys out there to bow hunting, I'd recommend giving a deer a good half hour or so just to make sure they've passed, because as I say before, you go up on an animal too early, like I've done on another hind. I've done went to touch like this, make sure she was dead, and she got up and bolted, but I ended up tackling her and
amazing. As I touched her with my hand, she jumped up and knocked me off to my feet. So I dropped me a bow and tackled her. And she dragged me down a bit of a hill. And my daughter came running after.
It's alive, but it's cold.
I'm holding on to the tree and holding on to the deer's neck. I'm calling my daughter over to come and give us a hand.
Yeah, we got that one anyway, but anyway, give them a bit of time to pass away before we go up and get them. But perfect day today, it's very nice weather, no wind, so I like a bit of deer stalking.
There's your lung shot. Okay, on the other lung there too, look, double lung shot. Okay, be facing that way. This is the exit lung. This is in the back of the first lung. Cut it through there. There's the exit there. Mr. Hart, that's okay. Double lung shot. Nice.
Nice. Happy with that. Okay. It's all good, the pigs will eat that. Oh, Jack, you can ask for a better double running shot than that. Yeah, good. Carry the whole thing back out. Nice. Good.
Carrying it like this, I let the arse end in to stop bleeding down the back of me.
See you on the other side. Oh, top of the ridge. Just about. He's stuck. Oh, bit of a hind, but why is a steep carry out? Hey, dog. Yes. Oh. This is on the quad. There's a steep carry out. Oh boy. I'm glad to see the quad, I tell you that much. Right then. Yeah, I didn't get that shot on camera, but I didn't have time to do anything else except for load up and shoot it. Spot the bloody arrow. Yeah. Hey dog. You found the arrow too. Good. Oh. Recovered the deer. Recovered my arrow. Can't ask for much more than that. Alright. Let's get this down back to the truck. Oh boy. Right, we'll just tie this one. It doesn't go anywhere. Yeah. Hold on.
We're good.
Okay.